نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد أما بعد فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا جعلنا ما على الأرض زينة لها لنبلوهم أيهم أحسن عملا All praise is due to Allah alone subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah's peace and blessings in abundance be upon our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. My dear and respected brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is beautiful. Our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Inna Allah jamil yuhibbul jamal." Allah is beautiful and Allah loves beauty. Allah Almighty, the Creator, the Lord of the universe, He made the whole universe beautiful. Earth to heavens and in between. And Allah says in the Holy Quran, Surah Al-Kahf, إِنَّا جَعَلْنَا مَا عَلَى الْأَرْضِ زِينَةً لَهَا لِنَبْلُوَهُمْ أَيُّهُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا Verily, surely, we have made what is on the earth as an adornment for it, so that we may test them أَيُّهُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا Who of them is better in deeds? Therefore, Allah's earth is beautiful. If we go through the ayats of the Quran, there are so many things Allah mentioned as plants, fruits, mountains, rivers, birds, animals. And there are so many to name. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَزَيَّنَّا السَّمَاءَ الدُّنْيَا بِمَصَابِيحَ وَحِفْظًا And we adorned the asman, the sky, the heavens of the dunya. The lowest heaven, the nearest to us, Allah says, وَزَيَّنَّا السَّمَاءَ الدُّنْيَا بِمَصَابِيحَ Allah adorned the sky with lamps. And Allah says in Surah As-Saffat, Inna zayyanna as-samaa'a ad-dunya bi zinatin al-kawakib. We have adorned, beautified the lowest heaven with the adornment of the stars. And in Surah Al-Mulk, Allah says, وَلَقَدْ زَيَّنَّا السَّمَاءَ الدُّنْيَا بِمَصَابِيحَ When we look into the creation of Allah Ta'ala from heaven to earth, stars,
moon, sun, galaxies, so many things above us.
When there are no clouds, look above. When there is sunshine and there is a spring, then look around. When river flows, mountains, green, beautiful with flowers. Allah says, Subhanallah.
Ya ayyuhan nabiy inna arsalnaka shahidan wa mubashiran wa nadhira wa da'iyan ila Allah bi'idhnihi wa sirajan munira. Oh, the people of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah declared in the Quran that He sent a messenger to the whole mankind who is shining like a candle. Sirajan munir.
And Allah Ta'ala says,
وَالتِّينِ وَالزَّيْتُونِ وَتُورِ سِينِينَ وَهَذَا الْبَلَدِ الْأَمِينِ لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ.
How many times Allah said, the oath, وَالتِّينِ وَالزَّيْتُونِ وَتُورِ سِينِينَ وَهَذَا الْبَلَدِ الْأَمِينِ.
Four oaths Allah mentioned and said, لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. Indeed, we created the mankind in the best form, the best shape that suited you all.
Allahu Akbar. How Allah Ta'ala mentions His creatures in the Quran.
الْمَالُ وَالْبَنُونَ زِينَةُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا.
Wealth, houses, businesses, sons, grandsons, زِينَةُ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا, the beauty of the life of the dunya. Then Allah Ta'ala said, our deen teaches us maintain the beauty of the universe. Keep it beautiful. Maintain it properly. And our deen came to teach us how to maintain the beauty, the cleanliness, to be handsome in this dunya following the deen of Allah Ta'ala. That is why Allah says in the Holy Quran,
Ya Bani Adam, khuzu zinatakum inda kulli masjid.
O sons of Adam, take adornment, beautify yourself, wear well in the kulli masjid, every time of prayer, going to prayer. Whether it is a prayer, whether it is a tawaf, or it is a hajj, adorn yourself. Inna Allah jameel yuhibbul jamal.
Allah is beautiful and Allah loves you to remain on it. That maintain this.
That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said,
Man kana lahu sha'r falyukrimhu.
Whomever Allah gave hair, whoever has hair, then honor and respect your hair. How to have a cut and wash them, comb them, nice beard, tidy up and combed and look like a gentleman. This is no doubt that our religion teaches us to be simple, not to be extravagant, not to be excessive in spending, but it teaches us to maintain the standard of life properly, rightly. And Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam so immense.
وَلَمَّا رَعَى رَجُلًا ثَائِرَ الرَّأْسِ فَقَالْ أَمَا يَجِدُ هَذَا مَا يُسَكِّنُ بِهِ شَعْرًا.
He saw a man with disheveled, scattered hair. And he said, doesn't he find to settle down his hair? wa ta'ala granted him with hair, and that is his responsibility, that to keep them clean and tidy. My brothers, cleanliness is so important, and it is very important. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَوْلَا أَنْ أَشُقَّ عَلَىٰ أُمَّتِي أَوْ عَلَىٰ النَّاسِ لَأَمَرْتُهُمْ بِالسِّوَاقِ مَعَ كُلِّ صَلَاةِ. If it were not difficult for my ummah or the people, I would have commanded them to use toothstick, miswak, at every time of the prayer. If it were not difficult. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam even said that the salah wuzu performed with the miswak, then prayer done is multiplied many times because of the cleanliness. And Sayyida Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha was questioned with what Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would begin when he would come to the house. She said, with miswak, subhanallah, that I'm going to my family, I'm going home. He entered the home in a way that he would begin with miswak. My brothers and my sisters, there are issues in our society, in our community, that bad smell of mouth, bad smell of the body has causes divorce in our society. Either men, they are out all day working, come home smelling tobacco, cigarettes, pan, spari, so much bad smell in the house, and wife is upset. My brothers, as we expect, when we come home, our ladies must be tidy. Sahaba Rizwanullahi alayhim ajma'in says, in the same way the ladies expect when their men come home, they should look better. Not a type of jinn. Then people complain there are jinns in our house. My brothers, we are already jinn in the house. When there is no cleanliness, no purification, and at the same time, husband will complain that, Imam, you need to advise my wife for what? That she need to be better clean and tidy when I come home. Then I said, oh my brother, what is your position? What do you do? The car we sit in, taxi we drive, full of wrappers, full of cigarette, full of cigar, full of tobacco, your clothes, your children, and you expect your ladies to be tidy, to be clean. Many years back, I requested a brother. I said, brother, if you have a time, I need a lift, if you can drop me somewhere. And he said, Imam, I don't have time, but I shall arrange someone for you to take you, to drop you and pick you up. I said, Alhamdulillah, Jazakallah. He sent somebody. I sat in the car, cold weather, and I opened the window of the car and traveled about 15 miles. And that brother, I asked him, brother, this is not the right way you are. He said, Imam, I am a student. I said, you are a student. But look the situation of your car, I can die in it. Look, the window is open. It is not only one way. It has to be always. We need to show that I am a Muslim. At-taharatun isful iman. Purification, tahara, cleanliness is half of the iman. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said,
لا تقبل صلاة بغير طهور.
Without wuzu purification, salah is not accepted. When we speak to Allah Ta'ala, when we stand in front of Allah Ta'ala, that is why Allah says, Ya Bani Adam, khuzu zinatakum inda kulli masjid.
My brothers, you did the history of humanity. Until today, there are hundreds of philosophy teaching humanity how to live a life. But I guarantee you, there is no philosophy, there is no religion in the world that discuss all matters of life A to Z as Islam does.
And that is why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did this. Sayyiduna Anas bin Malik radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he says, وَقَتَلَنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ فِي قَصِّ الشَّعْرِ وَتَقْلِيمِ الْأَظْفَارِ وَحَلْقِ الْعَانَّةِ وَنَبْفِ الْإِبِرِ أَلَّا نَتْرُكَ أَكْثَرَ مِنْ أَرْبَعِينَ يَوْمًا. Sayyiduna Anas bin Malik, he says, Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he appointed a time for us. He appointed strictly a time for us. And ulama al-sunnah, they say it is a wajib that we must trim the mustache, clip the nails, shave the pubic hair, pluck the hair under the armpits, and we should not leave them more than 40 days. Is there any deen, any religion in the dunya that teaches personal purification and tahara and cleanliness? Allah says, لَقَدْ خَلَقْنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. Best form, best shape, best molding. Ideal, Allah made you an ideal for the universe to look after it. And my brothers, this is our duty to teach our children. I'm afraid they are not here today. They're in school. The young children coming to adulthood, to pubic age, is the responsibility of fathers and mothers, and we neglect them. 10 years back, when I was teaching hadith, a student, 40 years old, reading Sunan al-Nisa'i, when we went to the hadith of personal purification and tahara, and he says, Imam, is this really the Islam? 40 years old. And he said he never knew that he should shave or pluck the underarm hair or pubic hair. Born Muslim, it is our responsibility to address these issues. And we are so lucky, anything for purification, cleanliness we do in the universe, we are rewarded for that. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, imatatul adha li tariq sadaqa, tahhiru afniyatakum. Where you live, your courtyards, your room, single people, single brothers. Brothers, don't mind me saying, this is my responsibility. I'm standing on the mimbar. It should speak the truth, not to hide. You go to single people living there, their room, hoovered, clean, cups, glass, excuse, I don't have a wife. And I would like to say, if you have a wife, and you have a sister, and you have a mother at home, you must thank Allah Ta'ala. You must prostrate specially to Allah and shukr that you have a lady in the house to maintain your house, to keep an order. You go to a brother, you say, brother, I live single, Hoover, no, I don't have a time. Your glass and glass smell, I don't have a time. The hero of riyatakum, your residence must be clean. Must look an example that this is the place where a Muslim lives. You meet a brother, brother come, it's time for salah. He says, no, I'm waiting for my son to finish the lesson. I want to pick him up.
And he says, why don't you keep the time for children that they should be free from masjid lessons half an hour before salah? Look. I said, brother, the children, they do salah with us. They learn how to do salah. You come inside the masjid, stand with your son, do the salah. He will learn, you learn. What he said? He says, my pant is not right. My underpant is not right. Oh, brother, you are a Muslim. You say, my pant not right? You urinate like a donkey? My underpant not right? Anytime you behave after a week, I'm not clean up, subhanallah. And we say, we are Muslims. May Allah guide us to the right path. And it's our responsibility. Visiting you today, that was my subject. I tried to speak very openly, clearly. These are our responsibility. We must discharge these responsibilities. Kullukum ra'in wa kullukum mas'ulun 'an ra'iyatihi. Every one of you is responsible and accountable and will be questioned about accountability, responsibility. Wa akhiru da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. الحمد لله اللهم لك الحمد حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على محمد صلاة وسلاما كثيرا كثيرا أما بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وأن المساجد لله فلا تدعوا مع الله أحدا And indeed the masajid, the mosques are for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And call not upon anyone along with Allah. My dear brothers and sisters, the masajid, the mosques are built and maintained for the sake of Allah alone subhanahu wa ta'ala. Dedicated in the name of Allah and built, maintained for the sake of Allah, hoping reward from Allah Ta'ala. Unfortunately, due to our cultural differences, due to our school of thoughts differences, due to our languages differences, we have divided masajid into my masjid, your masjid, Bengali masjid, Pakistani masjid, Afghani masjid, Arab masjid, this and that, and we divide the community like that. وَأَنَّ الْمَسَاجِدَ لِلَّهِ The masajid are for Allah. Maintain them for the sake of Allah. Donate for them for the sake of Allah. Not to get a name and fame in this dunya, but only hoping reward from Allah Ta'ala. It is our responsibility, obligation to build them, establish them, maintain them, as Alhamdulillah you have done in this masjid of Masjid Umar Nortigam. You have done a beautiful work. Many years back, you struggled to raise funds, and all masajids do that. Today you are protected, it looks beautiful. My dear brothers, I have come from all the way from near France. Kent, Maidstone, near Dover, Channel Tunnel. We established the masjid there 25 years ago. Alhamdulillah, now we have been given planning permission to rebuild it properly. And our budget is £1 million. I will not go into much details, but I have come to request you all, brother, to support us. And one beautiful thing I shall tell you, that Maidstone Masjid is the only masjid where all nationalities, all school of thoughts, all brothers and sisters, we pray all together under one roof. Is it scattered community? It is a big community. We have about 400 to 500 people praying there. But Alhamdulillah, so far 25 years, brothers from all nationality, over 50 nationalities, we are there and we pray together. And Alhamdulillah, now
anointed for this purpose. I am visiting your mosque today. I would like to thank all you brothers, Masjid Management Committee, Chairman, Secretary, Treasurer, and your beautiful Imam, Alama Professor Sheikh Abdul Rahman. All you allowed me to speak here. May Allah Ta'ala accept my old words and guide us to right path. I would like to request our Sheikh, your Imam, Professor Abdul Rahman, to lead the Salah, would make an appeal. And inshallah Ta'ala, Allah will help us, Allah will help you and us to carry on the work of Allah Ta'ala in the name of Allah Ta'ala for our future generations. Allahumma atina fi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina azab an-nar. Rabbana ighfir lana wa li ikhwanina alladhina sabaquna bil iman wa la taj'al fi qulubina ghillan lil ladhina amanu rabbana innaka ra'ufur rahim. Rabbana la tuzigh qulubana ba'da idh hadaytana wa hab lana min ladunka rahma innaka antal wahhab. Rabbi ighfir warham wa anta khairur rahimin. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun wa salamun 'alal mursalin walhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Assalamu alaykum.